Hello and welcome to another video in our how-to series. In this week's video we'll be talking about focal lengths. We'll be looking at what focal lengths are and what they do, why they are important to IP cameras, and most importantly, which focal lengths you should choose for your specific setup. So let's start off by explaining what focal length is and how they work. In simplest terms, a camera has a lens, that lens has a focal length, and that focal length acts as a guide for the field of view of your camera. Now, focal length is measured in millimeters, but here we're talking about field of view, which is measured in angles. So what does the millimeter measurement correspond to? Well, it's actually the distance between the sensor and the back of the lens. Changing this distance is what changes the field of view of your camera. And the best way to help visualize this is to think of the lens as a cardboard tube, just like this one. This tube represents a 12mm lens. Now, if you hold this up to your eye, the area that you will see out of the end of the tube or lens is actually quite small. Now, if we shorten the focal length to a tube representative of a 2.8mm lens like this and hold that up to our eye, the area visible will be much wider than the 12mm lens. In most cases with IP cameras, the focal length is fixed, which means you will have to choose a length or field of view that will suit the mounting location of your cameras. Although there is the option to purchase a PTZ or varifocal camera that will give you more choice in what your cameras can see, but these more often than not cost a lot of money and only really make sense if you have someone to operate them all the time, otherwise you're not really moving them that often and you'd probably be better off with a fixed camera. Going back to fixed focal lengths, most cameras use the standard options of 2.8mm, 4mm, 6mm and 12mm. Now you're probably thinking that seems like a very small scale, how can there really be that much difference between a 2.8 and a 12mm? Well, actually there is quite a big difference and we're going to show you some examples of different focal lengths to demonstrate whilst also pointing out the pros and cons of different focal lengths. So first off, let's look at a 2.8mm focal length. Now, 2.8mm is pretty much as wide as IP cameras go before they become panoramic cameras. Because of its wide 90 degree field of view, the 2.8mm option is incredibly versatile and offers you a huge amount of scene coverage. On the flip side, because of how wide the lens is, your image is likely to suffer from a lack of detail and clarity in faces, as well as suffering from some curvature at the edges of the image. A good example of how best to use a 2.8mm would be to place it in the far corner of an office or shop, giving you a full covering shot of the space. Then pair it with several tighter focal lengths, like a 4 or a 6mm, to get your more detailed shots of tills, desks or doorways. Next, you have the 4 and 6mm focal lengths. Now, the reason we're doing these two together is because they both fulfill roughly the same purpose, the mid-range focal length. They're a great choice if you want that little bit more clarity in your image while still having reasonable field of view. To be specific, it's 60 degrees for 4mm and 45 degrees for 6mm. But you have to be careful with mounting a tighter focal length. The reason being that changing the focal length is like zooming a standard video camera. If you have something framed up and then you zoom in, you have to step away from your subject to reframe it. So, with a fixed IP camera, you will have to mount the camera further away from the area you want to record to get everything in frame. The final focal length is 12mm. The 12mm focal length is one of the tightest fields of view that you will find when looking at fixed focal length IP cameras. It may seem limiting, but as mentioned earlier, when you narrow the field of view, you also zoom in to keep the same aspect ratio. This means you get a much clearer image, especially with a higher megapixel camera, making it the perfect choice for small, busy spaces like corridors, stairwells, and alleyways. Now, even after explaining the differences between each focal length, there's still probably people out there wondering why anyone would choose a focal length with a more restrictive field of view. Well, let me use a brief example. If you had a big room with two doors directly opposite each other and you wanted to capture any interaction with those doors, the obvious choice would be a 2.8mm placed halfway between both doors. But you are unlikely to see very much detail of what happens at the doors using a 2.8 lens, as you end up with so much warping at the edges of the frame. And so two cameras with tighter, clearer fields of view pointed at each door would be a much more secure way of covering the space. Thank you for watching and subscribing. If you haven't subscribed already, please do by clicking down here. Check the description below for links to our Facebook, Twitter and Google+. Follow the link here for our webshop, and if you want more videos like this, check out the playlist up here. Thanks again for watching and we'll see you in the next video.